మూలకేన అరుణ కుసుమమాల జ్ఞాన లంబోదరం తం మహరుడయ నివాసం శ్రీ గణేశం నమామి కృష్ణ ప్రదా కృష్ణ సనంతం రాత్రో కృష్ణం పునరుత్తిదాయి తే కృష్ణ దేహం ప్రవిశంతి కృష్ణం ఆజ్యం యథా మంత్రోక్తం హుతాశీ రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేదతే రఘునాథాయ నాథాయ సీతాయ పతయే బుద్ధిర్బలం యశోధైర్యం నిర్భయత్వమరోగత అజాగ్రం మత్పరుత్వం చ హనుమత్స్మరణాత్ భవేత్ చిత్రైః పదైశ్చ గంభీరైః వాక్యమానైః ఖండితైః గురుభావమువ్యంజయంతి భారతి శ్రీనేతీర్థవాక్ ప్రణమత్కామధేనుంచ భజత సురతరూపమం శ్రీభావభూతకృత్పాద చింతామణిం పాత్మహే పూజ్యాయ రాఘవేంద్రాయ సత్యధర్మరతాయ చ భజతాం కల్పవృక్ష్యాయ నమతాం కామధేనవే అన్నపూర్ణే సదా పూర్ణే శంకర ప్రాణవల్లభే జ్ఞానవైరాగ్య సిద్ధ్యర్థం భిక్ష్యాం దేహీ చ పార్వతీ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవేతి యోదే తస్య నిస్సరతే వాణీ జన్ను కన్యా ప్రవాహవత్ రాకాచంద్ర సమాన కాంతివహన నాకాభిరాజస్తుత మూకానామపి కుర్వతి సురధ్వనే వాక్వైభవం శ్రీకాంక్షే నగరి విహారరసికా శోకామహంత్రీ సతాం ఏకాం పుణ్యపరంపరాం పశువతే ఆకారిణీరాజతే సత్యం విధాతుం నిజవృత్యభాషితం వ్యాప్తిం చ భూతేషు అఖిలేషు చాత్మనః అపృశ్యత అత్యద్భుత రూపముద్వహన్ తం భేతమాయాం న మృగం న మానుషం Hanumanji is a deep devotee of the Lord. He is strong in body. Combination is very rare. Those who are strong in body are not steady in the mind. He is strong in body, steady in mind, firm in his heart, devout in his soul, humble in his dealings with the great, tough in his encounters with the wicked, gentle to his juniors, respectful to his masters, flawless in his character, adorable in his humility, compassionate to his devotees, an ideal creature created by the ideal creator, Shri Ram. That is Hanumanji. I tell children, the first Superman, the first Spider-Man in the world is Hanumanji. Who's the first one who flew? Long before the West had the concept of flying, the Ramayana said, our hero flies, and how does he fly? I've asked a simple question to everybody, many people don't answer, who can fly? I will ask you in the Sundarakanda tomorrow, who can fly? The Lord's messenger has flown across the ocean. How does he come to meet the Lord? Sri Rama and Lakshmana are walking along the mountainside of Rishyamukha. On the Rishyamukha of Parvata, Sugriva and his four Vanaras. Vibhishana comes with four Rakshasas. Sugriva has four Vanaras, which means every time we approach the Lord, we are four Purusharthas, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. That is why we have four people along with us. Here is Sugriva with his four Vanaras. Today, everybody is changing parties. Today you find this man in this party, the same man in the next party, the opposite party after a few days. How easily we change, how easily we change our loyalties, because there are no loyalties nowadays. Although Sugriva had been dethroned, although he had lost his wife, he had lost his kingdom, he had lost his property, he had lost his rights, there were four Vanaras who were still loyal, and among them is Shri Hanumanji, the main minister. Hanumanji is bold. Hanumanji does not curry favor. He doesn't want to flatter his master. When you find your master is going wrong, please have the guts to tell him that he is going wrong, even if you are afraid of losing your job. If you are really an advisor, That is what Hanumanji is. Sugriva sees Sri Rama and Lakshmana and says, Hanuman, they are spies. They are spies sent by my brother. They have come to kill me. Hanumanji says, you don't deserve to be the king at all. If you don't have the discerning eye to differentiate between a spy and divine human beings, you don't deserve kingship. You are just a Shakha Mruga. Shakha Mruga means a monkey which goes from branch to branch. Aho Shakha Mruga Tvamte Vyaktameva Plavandama. Calling his master an ape. He's calling Sugriva an ape. You are just a Vanara. You don't know who these are. Can't you see divine traits in them? Can't you see they are noble people? Can't you make out they are different from the ordinary humankind? Send me to them and I'll find out their true identity. Don't have misgivings. Don't have doubts. Sugriva, you have no idea who they are. Sugrivastu shubham vakyam shrutva sarvam sam hanumataha tata shuvataram vakyam hanumantam uvachaha. Dirgabahu vishalakshu sharachapasi dharinau kasanyasyat vayam drashtva ketau surasutopamau. Who will not be afraid of them, Hanuman? They are overpoweringly handsome, splendid human beings. Their personality is something which fascinates us and frightens us. Awesome human beings. Who will not be frightened of them? Hanuman says, tell, send me. I will go and find out. Hanumanji is sent to meet Sri Rama and Lakshmana. As he stands before Rama and Lakshmana, he is admiring them. For your information, for my information, it is Valmiki's video. My brother here has a video camera. Valmiki had a video camera thousands of years back. Pratyaksham vivadarshitam. Long before the video was discovered, you had Valmiki presenting Ramayana as it is happening right now here in Satyasai Nigamagavam. That is how you find the immediacy of effect. Hanumanji looks at them, how beautiful they are, how overpowering they are, overwhelming personalities, awesome personalities. Dhairyavantam suvarnabhau kauyuvam chiravasasau nishvasantau varabhujau pidayantau ima praja. As he is asking them who they are, he is describing them to us. You great men, who are you? Brave men, because they have got arms, bows and arrows. And who are they? They have got a golden complexion. And yet they are wearing matted hair and bark garments. The way they are breathing is like serpents, large serpents breathing hard. And you seem to be torturing all creatures around you with your overpowering personality. Padma Patrekshano. Sri Rama and Lakshmana turn to him and look at him. Your eyes are like lotus petals. Jata Mandala Dharinam, matted hair. Who are you? Rajarhu Amara Prakhyam Anyonya Sadrisho Viro Devaloka Ivagato. Did you lose your way from heaven? Did you lose your way? Did you take the wrong U-turn and came into the world? What brought you here? What brought you here? You seem to deserve all embellishments. The Ramayana says, they seem to deserve all embellishments. Actually, the adornments look adorned because Sri Rama used to wear them. I hope you understand. The Abhushanas looked Bhushana because Sri Rama used to wear them. Why is it that you are not wearing adornments? Why is it you are embellished? Sarva Bhushana Bhusharaha Kimartham Na Vibhushita. There are interpretations and interpretations in the Govindraji Vyakhyana. Govindraji Swami says, you are so handsome, arrestingly handsome. Your physique is something celestial, you should have covered your lovely physique with adornments, then you would not have evil eyes cast on you. Aapko nazar nahi lagti. Why did you expose your lovely physique to the world? You're so lovely. All the ornaments of the world are ornaments because you are wearing them, Rama. You are wearing them, Lakshmana. Why is it that you're not wearing ornaments? Why are you walking around in this world, the forest world, with matted hair and dark garments? What is the cause for this forest life that you've adopted, which doesn't suit your demeanor, your stately demeanor, your royal, lovely figure? What is it, Master? What is it? I still remember my Master saying, whenever he described Sri Rama and Lakshmana, it would reverberate in our ears. Dhairyavantau suvarnabhau kauyuvam chiravasasau nishvasantau varabhujau peedayantau imaprajam padmapatrekshanau veerau jatamandaladharinau anyonyasadrushau veerau devalokat ivagatau he Rama. I would say, and all of us knew, this is how my Master in his thundering voice would describe Sri Rama and Sri Lakshmana. Please have the courtesy to introduce yourself to someone before you ask that person who he is. This is just elementary, fundamental courtesy. Hanumanji teases us that. And now Hanumanji says, before you tell me who you are, let me tell you. There is a man. There's a man called Sugriva, a vanara called Sugriva, good fellow, helpless, handicapped, totally. His brother has sent him out of the kingdom. There's only one qualification he has, he's a dharmatma. Whenever in the Ramayana, you scan the Ramayana, let me tell you, you'll find the word dharmika, dharmatma, dharma. All these words will inevitably be there because it is a dharma grantha. The entire Ramayana is of dharma, by dharma and for dharma. There is a man, there is a vanara called Sugriva. Sugrivo nama dharmatma kaschit vanara yutapaha. Kaschit, kaschit is very important. Kaschit means someone, no, someone. Someone. Who is that kaschit? Manushyanam sahasreshu kaschit yatati siddhaye. Yatatamapi siddhanam kachinam vetti tattvataham. The Lord says, Arjuna, among millions, a few are coming towards me. Among those, a few know me. Among those, only some come to me. They are the chosen ones. I call it multiple filtering. It's filtering of humanity. Those who are the cream, they reach the Lord. And it is that kachit. Kachit vanarayutapaha viro vinikruto bratra jagat brahmati dukhitaha. Sugriva has not applied for help. Sugriva's application has not been signed by Sugriva. It is signed by Hanuman before asking Sugriva. Please give Hanumanji a big hand. We also send messengers, my Master used to say. You send a message to Ramaswamy, he'll take it to Krishnaswamy. And Krishnaswamy will give it to Narasimhachari. And finally there will be a total conclusion, Tower of Babel. That is how we send messengers. That is how we send messengers. But if you have a messenger like Hanumanji, you're naturally victorious. You're naturally successful in all your endeavors. Even before anything could be said about Sugriva, Hanumanji has applied for help. Because he doesn't want the Lord to feel it was an afterthought. After meeting Sri Rama, after meeting Sri Rama, had Sugriva asked for help, it would be an afterthought. He doesn't want it to be afterthought. It is to be a spontaneous, natural asking for help. And that is why he says, he wants your help. Praptoham preshivatena Sugrivena Mahatmana Yuvadhyam Sahadharmatma Sugriva Sakhyamichyati. Sugriva has said nothing of the sort. Sugriva is trembling in his shoes, thinking that Rama and Lakshmana are spies, and yet Hanumanji says, he wants your sakhya, sakhya, sakhya. Bhagavata in the Saptama Skanda tells you there are 9 types of devotion. All our children come back from school learning stupid rhymes. The first time I went to London, I asked these people in London, why should Humpty Dumpty sit on a wall and have a fall? Why can't you teach them meaningful rhymes? We run a Veda Pathshala. At the age of 3.5, 4, children come to us. Within 1 month, you should see them chanting the Vishnu Sahasranama, the Gita, the Lalita Sahasranama, and hundreds of Vedic mantras at the age of 4. By the time they finish their graduation in 9 years, they will be chanting 240 hours of Veda without looking into a book. Clap for them. 240 hours. Today, all our memory is in the chip. No? I always tell my audience, the laptop makes up for the lapses. No? You don't even know your spellings. That's the problem today. What machines have become our crutches, that we have lost our natural intelligence. We have no time to develop this natural intelligence. Here is the little child called Prahlada coming back from school and telling his father, I have learned about 9 types of devotion. I tell my Hindu friends, you can approach the Lord according to your aptitude. There is no need to approach the Lord from only one angle. Swaranam Kirtanam Vishnu, Swaranam Padasevanam, Archanam Vandanam Dasyam, Sakhyam Atmanivedanam, Sakhyam Atmanivedanam. Out of the 9 types of devotion, 8 types we can approach the Lord with, except Sakhya. Sakhya we cannot. We cannot accept Sakhya until the Lord accepts us. The Lord has to accept us as our friend, as His friend. We cannot call Him our friend. He wants you to extend your hand of friendship. Lokanatha pura bhutva sugrivam nathamichyati sarvalokasya dharmatma sharanya sharanam pura gurur me raghavasoyam sugrivam sharanam gataha. Hanumanji says, enough sir, don't embarrass us. I think the animal kingdom needs humanizing friends like you to come to us. Please come and humanize us. We are an animal kingdom, animal kingdom. We need human beings like you. We need human beings. On his shoulders, Rama and Lakshmana are seated. In a few minutes, they are there in the Rishyamukha Parvata. In a few minutes, Hanumanji has explained to Sugriva who the Lord is. And Sugriva stands before the Lord in all humility and says, Narayana, Sri Rama, this is Sugriva extending his trembling hand to you. O Master of the world, unconquered, unconquerable Master of the world, today an ordinary ape is asking you, will you condescend to touch my hand and make me your friend? I don't deserve, but you can condescend. Whenever I think of this beautiful bond between man and God, tears come to my eyes. The Lord has created so many relatives around us. The moment we are born, cousins and uncles, aunts and brothers-in-law and sisters-in-law, everywhere you find there, hundreds and thousands of them, particularly when you have a wedding at home, you find an inexhaustible list of relatives. I studied English for 17 years and taught English for 23 years, but I found English is the most illogical language in the world. Those who are unrelated are called relatives. If you are happy, they are sad. If you are unhappy, they are happy. Example, a great man called Duryodhana. Duryodhana goes to Shakuni and says, Mamaji, yes, my nephew, what is the problem? I am sad. Why are you sad? I have sent the Pandavas with a game of dice, which is a game of life. I sent them to the forest. That's the problem, Mamaji. What is the problem? They are happy in the forest. That's why I'm unhappy. Now, what can you do to such people? No. This is called jealousy. That is how 90% of relatives react to our fortunes or misfortunes in this manner. That's why the Lord created a beautiful phenomenon called friendship. A friend is one who loves you all your life. A friend has no ego. If there is ego in friendship, friendship breaks. You can shout at your wife, she will not bring you coffee in the morning if she brings. You can shout at your children and they will not come back for the vacation. You shout at your friend, he comes back in 10 minutes and says, you're okay? What's the problem? I know you're letting out steam. I know you're unhappy about something else. It does not matter. For you, your friend is very dear and you are very dear to him. Your mother's funeral is his mother's funeral. Your daughter's wedding is his daughter's wedding. Man, woman, whoever is your friend stands by you through thick and thin. Do you know sometimes when a friend dies, the other friend also passes away very soon. He or she cannot live. No, not after my friend has gone from the world. Imagine the difference between the relative and the friend. Whenever I analyze friendship and relationship, I always say, a friend is one who demands, who never demands anything from you. The relative is one who doesn't stop demanding. A friend never measures what you give. The relative always evaluates what you give. The friend has no ego. The relatives thrive on ego. The friend is one who will never abandon you. The relative is one who abandons you when you are in the nadir of life. The friend is one for whom you are important. The relative is one for whom he or she is important. Imagine when the Lord becomes your friend, how happy must your life be. All the friends of the Lord, I envy them. Uddhava, Arjuna, Bhishma, Drona and Kripa were jealous of that Lord who was driving the chariot for Arjuna every morning. Kanha Karataya. That Lord of the world comes to Arjuna and says, Saab gadi tayyar hai. Every morning he reports for duty. Are you not jealous of Arjuna? I'm jealous of Arjuna. I'm jealous of Sudama. I'm jealous of Sugriva. I'm jealous of Vibhishana. I'm jealous of all these devotees of the Lord who are friends of the Lord. Do you know, my dear listeners, that in the Ramayana, at one juncture, Hanumanji lights a fire. And Sugriva and Sri Rama go around the fire holding hands and saying, we are friends till death. Do you know that? There can be a panigrahana between two friends also. Fire becomes a witness to their eternal friendship. That is the way Hanumanji links the great characters. I always felt Hanumanji is the big flyover. He is the big link bridge between great characters in the Ramayana, between Sugriva and Sri Rama, between Mother Sita and Sri Rama, between Vibhishana and Sri Rama, and finally between Bharata and Sri Rama. Give him a big hand. That is how much. Very important role he plays.